that you may experience them in freedom of broadcast as we start out at 5:15. But nevertheless, we're here to provide some insight in this pregame hour before the ballgame, and John Marlowe, voice of choice, gives you his analysis and insight to tonight's ballgame. Welcome, John.
Well, Vic, tonight is what novels are written about. We've got the growing world at perennial powerhouse, IBL, five-time champions. We've got the Calexico Bulldogs coming up to their own. They're going to get on tonight at 7:30 at Willis Wood Field. The Bulldogs have had a very successful season thus far, coming in 7-1. 2-0 win, not allowing any IBL opponents any points whatsoever, and only allowing 7 points in the month of October. The Bulldogs, with their vaunted defense, man, are going to show the community, the people from the Raleigh, the people from the Valley, where Bulldog football was meant to be played by. And Coach Cunningham and the rest of the school have prepared these boys the last couple of weeks, and they're really excited. I'm talking about Friday Night Lights, man. I'm talking about Calexico High School.
These are the times I wish I had a tripod. Just put out a tripod and go have a beer.
Without a doubt, have been the offense. The defense. Well, the offense too, scoring points. But mostly, I would consider the defense as one of the key factors in their success. Because aside from allowing 51 points in 8 games, the Bulldogs allowed 32 against Escondido and 12 against Coachella, and the rest has all been practically shut out with the exception of Bogle. Everybody else has not been able to score. So I believe that the main key for tonight's game is that our defense is on all cylinders. If we have that tonight, then you can expect for sure a victory at Moore Field.
Well, we're talking about defense, John. The Bulldogs lead San Diego County with 5 shutouts thus far in the season. They gave up a late second touchdown against Schofield after being convincingly ahead 42-0. But John was talking about tonight, the key for Calexico is to play smart, because Raleigh's coming in with a loaded offense as well. The average of 34 points a game. The key to the run game is Bobby Miles. Bobby with 114 points. Good game. He has 14 touchdowns to his credit. And he can't take anything away from the team of all head coaches in the Great Valley, John Bishop, who has led Raleigh to 5 consecutive championships. Raleigh will be ready, but the coach Cunningham and Cunningham will be ready to meet that challenge. And all you got, John, is this big test. There's a winning. The Imperial Valley fans are looking forward to it. And it's 7:30 in the South Carolina
Well, John Bishop reported being, like you said, the dean of Imperial Valley football coaches, currently coaching. Bottom line is, and we must not forget Andrew Van Diver. His first name is Van Diver would be for Broad, and he's also Adrian Van Diver, and he's also running the ball a lot along with the quarterback Grant Elmore. We should see a lot of beer option football sweeps going side to side as our scout from Chula Vista went down to visit them last week at Palo Verde, Georgie Carrillo, who videotaped the first half and gave me a scouting report that we would qualify for a tale of two cities.
Well, let's talk about the game itself, John. We're celebrating the Willis Wood game at Willis Wood Field. We're honoring our veterans and Lou Bogle, who coached the Calexico Bulldogs from 1942 to 1945, 4 consecutive football championships, and he's the one that is responsible for introducing the Garnet and White uniforms as Calexico used to be yellow and white before they were coached better now. Okay, can you give our listening audience some insight about the Willis Wood game and how it's been celebrated?
Well, the Willis Wood game started back in 1997 with a very good friend of mine, Mike Charles, who played for Calexico High School back in the 60s and also played for Ivan City, and he was celebrating the 40-year he played Calexico junior 11, and he and I started writing, responding on email, we're saying that Willis working together with Lightroll, my first line in New York, and now promoting the football program at Calexico High School. One of the ways was to delve into the history of Calexico High School and football play. We found out that after these first 5 years, we're on the sixth year now, that there is a rich history of football in Calexico's beginning in 1915. Our first game was our first war game was back a few years, and we inaugurated the 57th, and then we also, in 98, we honored the 48 champs and Coach Ace Parker, and in 99, we honored that magical team in 1974, that we find ourselves comparing this team with, and in the year 2000, it was Coach Al Gutierrez, 2001, last year, with the Golden Bulldogs, and that dated back to 1915 to 1945. And then, of course, this year we are not only military veterans, Calexico High School military veterans, alumni, and with the addition of Lou Bogle, who won four consecutive seasons. Now, history, we also found that they were Covington from the 10 years from 37 to 45.
That's
Mom!